The value of table grapes depends greatly on their visual appearance. White grapes should be clean and free from visible defects, which detract from the berry appearance. External skin browning of white grapes is an undesirable defect that can result in downgrades of quality and price paid for the fruit. This short InnoGrape video aims to summarise the factors that contribute to the development of browning and present solutions to reduce or prevent its occurrence. Browning is a complex problem of many fruits, including table grapes. It occurs when cells in grape berries break down naturally during fruit ripening. The degradation of cell membranes results in the mixing of the enzyme polyphenol oxidase with natural phenolic compounds in the fruit. The mixing of these compounds triggers oxidation reactions that lead to tissue browning. Studies have described several different types of skin browning. Net-like browning appears as necrotic, dashed-like streaks that progress from the blossom end towards the cap stem of the berry. This type of browning can be severe. Staler end russet spots are characterised by irregular or circular-shaped spots at the blossom end of the berry. Mottled browning appears as brown blotches or spots on the berry surface. Contact or friction browning appears where berries or leaves rub. Peacock spot appears as circles or half circles with a clear centre on the surface of berries where adjacent berries touch. This type of defect is sometimes associated with chemical droplets or too much wetting agent. Another common type of browning is ambering, which is caused by direct exposure and damage by the sun. One factor that may influence the onset of berry browning is the integrity of the cell wall and cell membranes. Some table grape management practices, like the use of plant growth regulators, may worsen browning or prevent browning. Gibberellic acid, used to increase the size of seedless grapes, works by enlarging berry cells, but also reduces cell density. Berry growth stretches the skin and reduces skin thickness. The sizing effects of gibberellic acid is greater on cells at the base of the berry compared to the top of the berry. It is possible that applications at fruit set may contribute to stalar end russet spots by enhancing cell wall and membrane degradation, leading to cell leakiness and the oxidation reactions that cause browning. In contrast, plant growth regulator CPPU and calcium nutrient applications may reduce or prevent berry browning by delaying the ripening process and slowing cell wall and membrane degradation. Other management practices to prevent the onset of browning include adjusting bunches to hang freely and removing leaves around bunches to prevent rub marks. Excessive use of gibberellic acid should be avoided on sensitive varieties. Calcium fertilisers and a low-rate CPPU application at fruit set may improve cell wall structure and membrane integrity. Furthermore, harvest should not be delayed on varieties prone to skin browning associated with advanced maturity. To prevent browning related to sunlight and heat damage, sensitive varieties should not be planted on weak sites or poor soils where canopy growth is compromised. Good irrigation and nutrition management and selection of more vigorous rootstocks is also important. Finally, when removing leaves around bunches, do not expose ripening fruit to direct sunlight, which can lead to amber or yellow discoloration. Following these guidelines will generally improve the appearance of white table grapes and increase their value in the marketplace. This video is brought to you by InnoGrape, a table grape extension program supported by the Australian Table Grape Association, with funding from the Foundation for Rural and Regional Renewal and the William Buckland Foundation.